Hello and welcome. I am Dr. Anil Joshi. Welcomes you to today's lecture. It is slightly different than what we have got on our websites, and most of the time the teaching lectures aren't pertaining to certain topic on which illustrations are given, lectures are given, and the knowledge is delivered. But today's topic is going to be on the mammography procedure, and that also over the frequently asked questions. Why we have taken this topic is because we have to join a global program that is going on to decrease the morbidity and mortality through the breast as well as cervical cancers. Through this project, we are contributing to their breast cancer project. That means we are trying to reduce breast cancer cases as much as possible. Therefore, it is essential that certain knowledge has to be given to the people. Now, X-ray mammography has got a major role to play in reduction of mortality and morbidity of the breast cancer due to its ability to detect it in very, very early stage. A stage where we can really offer patient good prospective of life. Therefore, we must know how a mammography works, what are the types of mammographies, and when to do it, and when to advise it, and when to stop it, and when to start it. I acknowledge with thanks and gratitude my mentors, that is the management of BLDE, Deemed University, Sri B.M. Patil Medical College and Research Center, Vijayapur, where most of the material is prepared and most of the videos are from the same department. I also acknowledge with thanks staff of the Radio Diagnosis Department, IT and Photography Department, without whom this project would not have been possible. Now, what are the guidelines for the screening mammography? Now, mammography is grossly divided into two. One thing is a screening mammography and second is a diagnostic mammography. Screening mammography, the meaning of screening mammography is you are going to do mammography or you are going to screen the population when there are no breast symptoms. Patient do not have any complaint as far as breast is concerned, and in that situation, you advise them mammographies, you perform them because you want to detect the onset of the disease much earlier than it really goes out of our hands or when it advances. Because the basic principle of malignancy is early you detect, better prognosis you can give. That's why the screening mammography has got maximum role, and the countries where the incidence of breast cancer has gone down, that is the mortality and morbidity through the breast cancer has gone down, are because of the screening mammography programs. Because this is a program which can detect the patient before the disease manifests or before it goes out of our hand or it advances in a such a stage where we cannot really offer them the good prospects. The second is diagnostic mammography. There is slight difference in it. In diagnostic mammography, patient has got complaints. May not be the complaint related to the breast cancer. It may not be related to the future of the breast cancer program, but we have to attend it. Now, there are a lot of complaints in these, like there may be mastalgia, there may be discharges, there may be skin changes, or there may be some heaviness the women are feeling. In that situation, it is our duty to screen them and see to that they do not have a malignancy. Now, the term diagnostic mammography of the breast is used to diagnose the breast changes, such as when there is a lump, there is a pain, there is a nipple thickening or discharges of the skin, discharges to the nipple or the skin thickening, that is a body orange type of skin, or the changes in breast size, that there may be a mass in some breast which increases in size, and patient can present with just a complaint that the breast size has increased. Now, what is screening mammography? It is a criteria laid down by the American College of Radiology, which we are following. What American College of Radiology has recommended? That it is annual screening starting from age of 40 for a woman at average risk of breast cancer. That means they have laid down certain criteria which are called as the risk criteria. If the woman do not have these risk criteria, then the mammography can be started at the age of 40 years, and there are also criteria when we are going to stop it. So where there are no known positive history earlier, when there are no breast complaints, when the patient is totally asymptomatic, it can be started at the age of 40 years. Now, what's about the increased risk? Now, for women with increased risk of breast cancer, American College of Radiology has recommended imaging screening for the breast cancer. So what they say, yearly starting from the age of 30 years, but not before the age of 25 years. Women with certain BRCA1 or BRCA2 mutations have first degree relatives, that is a mother, sister or daughter, who are proved to have that bronchogenic, that is a breast cancer. Now, the woman with more than 20% lifetime risk of the breast cancer on the basis of family history, both maternal and paternal, the woman with mothers or sisters with premenopausal breast cancer earlier than the age of diagnosis of the youngest affected relative, the mammography has to be started. So these are the two criteria. If they got near relatives who had a breast cancer, maybe little later, then you started at 30 years. If they had it before the age of 30 years, then you have to start accordingly. So the screening mammography starts much before, that is when patient do not have complaint, then also we do it. Now, what is the age at which annual screening with mammography should be stopped? When the life expectancy is less than 5 to 7 years on the basis of age or comorbidities, that is the average age of any population nowadays is considered 100. So unless somebody crosses the age of 95 or they have got certain comorbidities by which they are likely to succumb before that. When the abnormal result of screening would not be affected because of the age or comorbid morbidity. So if anyway the life is going to come an end, there is no need for screening mammography to be done, number one. Number two, that patient can have comorbidities, patient can have cancer somewhere else, there may be certain other diseases. In that condition, the screening mammography may not be continued. Now, what are the indications for diagnostic mammography? As we discussed, these patients will have complaint, they will come with the symptoms. What the symptoms? Like breast clump, nipple discharge, focal breast pain. Now, this pain has to be cyclic or non-cyclic. We have already had a video on the types of the breast pain which needs attention and we do not, whether it is cyclic, non-cyclic, they have got periodicity, like if they are coming before the periods, all these things contribute to the importance of it. Now, follow for previously evaluated mammographic findings, we have to do a diagnostic mammography. Then Bayer's breast imaging reporting and detection system. This is one of a standardized method throughout the world to report the breast cancers. Now, if patient has got in such a category, which we are going to discuss subsequently, where there can be elevation from 3 to 4 or from 4 to 5, usually from 3 to 4 are the more candidates who needs a diagnostic mammography more closely and more precautiously. Now, let us go to the technical consideration. Now, since this is something like a questionnaire, when to do mammography? We are discussing same thing, that is the suspected complaints if you have got, or even if you don't have any complaints, then what is the age when you should start? Now, let's go back to it again. Mammography is a X-ray procedure. So once you decided to go for it, when you should do it? Now, there are two things. Premenstrual phase, if patient has got complaint, then usually it is avoided. Now, if patient has got premenstrual phase, usually it is done immediately following the menses. Now, in childbearing age, we may start it at 30 or before that. It is important that pregnancy has to be ruled out. So, patient should avoid, before coming to the mammography, powders, cosmetics, over the breast and in armpits, since these can cause artifacts. Now, idea about the breast implants, tattoos should also be given prior, because essentially the technique we'll have to modify and we'll have to make some findings of clinical. Now, usually it involves 3 x-rays of each breast. So totally patient has to undergo around 6 radiographs during the mammography if it is bilateral. Now, when mammography is contraindicated, like contraindication to the X-ray, that is first or second trimester of pregnancy, prior radiation therapy to the chest mediastinum, then active collagen vascular disease. These are the absolute contraindication. So menstrual history, if it is ambiguous, then best is to do it postmenstrual between 5 to 10 days. So that should be kept in mind because it is potentially an X-ray procedure. So it involves radiation. Now let us come to the another question. What is the technique of mammography? Now we want to know the technique. Now let us go first to the principle. The principle is best is composed of the fatty tissues and glandular tissues and connective tissues. These are the three constituents of the breast. Now normal and cancerous tissues in the breast have small X-ray attenuation difference between them. So unless we have got a good technique, good contrast, a normal tissue and a breast tissues may resemble that of the cancer. There is very few differences. You need to have experienced eye as well as a good technique. Now need X-ray equipment specially designed to optimize breast cancer detection. Now if you want to detect it properly, you must have a proper mammography unit. Routine X-ray machine is not used for mammography. Mammography uses a different machine which has got different tube. Since the technique is different, it uses low KV and high MS technique, so tube needs to be of different type and the tube designs are different. Now what type of tube we need? Tube has got certain things that it has to produce X-rays, anode and cathode. So cathode and filament circuits it has got low operating voltage. It KVs are below 35 to 40. Why? We want to have a good contrast pictures. Now the thickness of breast tissues is also not much. In that way, by compressing it, we reduces it. So low KV, that it means we have to go for high MS. So typically 23 to 24 KVs are the lowest. Now dual filament in a focusing cup is required. 0.3 mm contact and 0.1 mm magnification focal spots are used. Small focal spots are preferred because they give sharper image, then minimize geometrical blurring, then maintains spatial resolutions, and typical tube currents are 100 mA, that is plus or minus 25, or larger 0.3 mm focal spot. So these two are important to get a good quality picture. Then 25 mA, that is plus or minus 10 mA for a small focal spot. These are the specification for the tube. These are important because, as we said, the technique requires normal tissues and cancer tissues to be separated properly, and they are fairly close to each other. Now once you decided to go for a mammography, once you approach a radiology department, a suitable day is considered. Now on this suitable day, initially we have to give a proper idea out to the patient as to what is going to be a mammography procedure. This all is given in the mammography room. Patient is shown a mammography machine in the room itself. We do a counseling. We explain to them what is going to be the breast procedure. Whether patient will have pain or not is always there a question. Now the mammography uses compression. The compression is automatic, but it can be controlled manually. So we give as much as patient can tolerate. So these two things are explained to the patient. We have to compress the breast so that a clear picture will be obtained. There will not be movement with the respiration, and with that we can have a clear picture. So once we give a clear idea to the patient, then we only take patient for the mammography. Now once the explanation is done, patient will have to give a change. In that we give patient a gown which has got front opening. So patient cannot keep anything above the waist, especially jewelries or anything that can cause artifact. Like a patient has got used cosmetics, then if there are tattoos, then that needs to be properly informed to the technician. Then once we give a gown with open front, it is very comfortable for patient without any embarrassment to undergo the mammography procedure. It is always the females that takes this procedure. Now for positioning of the patient, it is always a female technician who try to keep the breast in its normal position as far as possible. So also, the anatomical positions are palpated and kept on the table in such a way that is a cradle, paddle, what you call you, so that there will not be any folds which can reduce the imaging accuracy. Because always we have to go for a follow-up mammograms, and follow-up mammograms, there has to be proper reproducibility. Proper reproducibility, proper comparison, a technique has to be standardized all the time. So what are the parameters we use? Are the perimeters, then pectoralis muscle and posterior nipple line. Now there are three things. One thing is perimeter, then pectoralis major and posterior nipple line. These three lines are also identified when we take a mammograms. So a technician sees to that they are properly seen, because unless we see a pectoralis major, we will not know whether there are any axillary nodes. So the pectoralis major has to be seen properly, axilla has to be seen properly, and many times we have to see a retroareolar region. So this is a normal CC, craniocaudal. So craniocaudal is the first view. I told you there are three views. This is the first. This includes maximum amount of breast tissues in axial plane. This is also important when you want to know the retronipple region. Then it visualizes medial breast tissues, that is the cleavages, then visualization of pectoralis major on approximately 30% of the CCs. In CC, to see a pectoralis major is really difficult, especially if the units are not using mammography specialized cassettes. But is okay, because the other X-rays we are going to see this pectoralis major and the folds. Now second is the mediolateral oblique, that is popularly called as MLO. This is inclusive of all the breast tissues with perimeter. Then pectoralis muscle fully visualized and should be seen. This is one of the criteria. Then tissue azar well separated and tissues visualized back to the retromammary space is also seen. And that is why it is very important to know if there are any lymph nodes, as you are seeing in this case. I'll show you, this is a pectoralis muscle fold, these are the breast tissues, and this is a node. So if you want to know whether there is any axillary nodes, this view is extremely important and you have to include pectoralis measure in it. Now the arm of the unit is rotated 45 degrees so that the cassette is parallel to the pectoralis major. This all we are going to show you in the video which is coming subsequently. The film holder is kept high in axillary fossa. The arm is abducted at elbow. Now coming to the reporting portion. A reporting also includes a part of a team. We are part of a team which takes patient's care to reduce the breast cancer, and radiologists being a first line, that is we detect the patients in screening mammography. So it is very important that we should have our proper networking with all clinicians as well as those who are going to take patients further management. So what is the standard? That is standard reporting. It should have indication, then breast compositions. It can have ABCDs, that is the denseness of the stroma versus the fatty. Whether breast has got more fat tissues or it has got more glandular tissues, or it has got a balance of it, that needs to be specified. Then important findings are mass, asymmetry of breast, then architectural distortion, calcification, associated features, comparison to the previous studies, and final assessment category. This all we have covered in a respective topic in some other lectures. In this report, only idea is to give how a networking is established, how the examination is conducted, and to answer the frequently asked questions by the patients, and one of it is how a reporting is done. So to give a management, recommendations are the another feature, and to communicate unsuspected findings with the referring clinician. It's a teamwork, as we are showing you. It's a teamwork which is going to reduce the breast cancer incidence, morbidity and mortality in future days. Now reporting system has got a standardization, that is called as Bi-Rad system. Now, what Bi-Rad system has got? It takes into consideration the different stage, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 0, 1 is negative, the stage zero is there is no point in reporting, so do a repeat study. We cannot comment anything on it. The category one is a negative. Routine screening is essential. That is what is told to the management. And likelihood of cancer is practically zero in it. Now, two are the benign. That is routine screening we advise. And essentially, the chances of malignancy here are zero. Now, Bayer system gives idea what are the chances that patient may develop in future. Number one, what is the future management treatment that is all given by this. So, a patient, when he gets a report in the hand, he should know in what category the patient stands. And all these things are extensively available over the net. So, they can also see it and they can know the outcome of it. If it is 0, 1, 2, patient don't have to worry. From 3 onward, there are different things. Like if we are getting category 3 on BI-RADS, there always is a top up with sonography, and we can try to see whether it fits in 3 only or it can go to the 4. And 4 onward, there has to be a proper tissue diagnosis required. So 5, 6 are practically, as far as diagnostic mammography are concerned, already the diagnosis is established, so hardly there is any role for the radiologist. We have just to go for a staging, which is helpful for the management. Now, whatever we have seen in the theoretical aspect, let us see how the X-ray or radiographs are taken. First, you explain to the patient what is the constituency of the unit. First is the cone, above that was a tube. The tube has to got proper focus. Now, we are shown a paddle. By paddle, you can reduce the distance between a cradle and a cassette platform. Now, if you can see, the cradle is coming closer and closer. The hand is used just to show you where the breast is going to be. Now, the radiation will be coming from the tube, and there are certain marks on the cradle as to how to fix a patient. Now, while doing all these things, a technologist had to adjust a breast in such a way that there will not be any folds. Now, whatever is compression being given will come in the meter. It will be shown. See, it is shown on the meter that how much compression, and it stops automatically. Once the pedal is pressed, there will be compression, and once the maximum compression achieved, automatically you will have to go for a exposure. And once the exposure is done, the compression is relieved by itself, and there is no need additionally to press any buttons. So that's how a mammography works, that you adjust the patient, you give the compression. Why compression? Is to get proper visualization of the breast tissues. It reduces the thickness, number one. Number two is to reduce the respiratory movements. So these are the two principles of compression. The technique is explained to the patient. Patient fear complex is gone. They cooperate better. And now here we have shown you by using a sponge how a machine works. So all the time when the process is going on, patient is explained that though there is compression increasing, you don't worry about it, because after certain stage, after certain compression is achieved, observe the meter, it will be showing you change in the compression, how much it is going to be. So after a correct compression is given, now she's communicating with the patient and explaining first, then how it is going to be, and then the actual patients will be taken. Patient will be same explaining that way, that you don't worry about the pain. Once the certain compression is achieved, it will get automatically relieved. Now, this is a CC first, what we are showing you. Now, after CC is taken, now you will have to go for a change in the we'll go for a first is CC, then is MLO, lateral oblique, and then is the lateral. These are the three things which machine has got different arrangement. Either you can do it manually or you can do it by pressing the buttons. So both type of machines are available and you can get the things done. So this is the first, it was shown as CC. Now we'll show you, this is a medial lateral oblique MLO. Now in MLO, again the patient is taken out. Now you see how the breast is compressed. This is the medial oblique. Again, patient is explained in the local language as to she don't have to worry. The compression will stop by itself once it achieves the correct standard, and after that this is MLO. Then we'll have to go for a lateral, that is the last radiograph. The DTD lash machine is rotated. Now these movements, both things are available. Certain machines you can do it automatically, certain machines you will have to do it manually. Now the height is adjusted to the patient's height, the exposures are adjusted. See, now the compression is adjusted, the machine position is adjusted. Compression adequate. Now patient will explain that she will be going for a exposure. Now this is the exposure. What are their factors in the hair? You will have to adjust the filter, number one. You will have to give the KV, MAS. Usually MAS in between 125 to 150 depending on the thickness required. Then once you expose it, now she has exposed it, the compression will get automatically released. So this is the end of the process. The MAS you can adjust, KVs you can adjust. These are the different settings on the machine. There are filters also, and there are compression also, how much you can give. What is the radiation dose given can be calculated at the end of by a simple mathematics, which is already covered in some other lectures. The one of the part of this program is screening mammography, diagnostic mammography, and then third important fact comes as a self breast examination. It is the examination conducted by the patient on herself, by herself. So this comes on both ways. Once we do the mammography, we explain patient this technique she has to undergo. We also tell her if she finds anything, she will have to report back. Now, self-examination is for detection of majority or major abnormalities. Then it is potential life-saving. Then monthly examination, the end of menses, is something she can remember. She has to perform it on herself. We teach her. Now we'll tell you also how the patients are explained about it. And usually what you really need is just a mirror. So it detects majority of breast abnormalities. It is potentially life-saving because it detects your cancer very early. Then monthly examination at the end of menses is something you can remember and perform. And what you really need is just a mirror. You will have to look into it and do what we are going to show you. Now, just first the inspection. Just stand in front of mirror, keep your chest without clothes. Then see it first, the skin over it, skin changes. Then some there is redness, some there is swelling, some there is change in the skin, that is body orange type of skin, wrinkles are more. Then there is any visible lump. Then nipple changes, this can be either way. There can be inversion, there can be crusting, or there can be some other changes which you will have to remember. Then this is how we have shown you this has to be done. Now, second step, raise your both arms in front of mirror. So this all process is done in front of the mirror. So breast should rise equally on both sides, and watch for the dimpling or retraction, and if there is any abnormal movement. Essentially what you are doing here are you are going to move the pectoralis major, and you are going to observe a symmetrical movement. So it is the next step. Now what is the next? Further than that, feel for the lump. We know it is not there, possible, but sometime if it is a benign lesion stamped by a radiologist, by investigation, we ask for a long-term follow-up. In that you have to feel it by raising the arm, see the movement, feel the opposite with the opposite hand, and feel a marble in a bag of rice appearance. each and every patient after the mammography, a technician, who of course is a female, who explained to the patient how it is to be done. They clear their doubt and they train their hands also to feel the lump. Use the middle of your finger. See how you are supposed to see. Fingertips are too sensitive. That's why you have to use your fingertips. Then the palm is too insensitive. So you'll have to use fingertips more. Palm may be used if it is large, but for small, it has to be a fingertip. The middle portion of the finger is just the right place or right thing. Then move your hand in small circular way. Stay in one place while curling with your hands and feel the thickness of the size of the marble what we have shown you or what has been told to you when your mammography was done. See here. Then move to another locations. You have to see for the both sides. Work your way around the breast in a clockwise fashion using a small circle of the hand as you go. Make sure that entire breast is filled. Now you have to see the tail of the breast also, that is which goes into the axilla. The breast is not a perfectly round shape. It has got tail which normally extends into the armpit. Then make sure to feel the lumps in that portion also. Make sure also that there is nothing in the breast as well as in the axillary tail. Then feel the armpit for the nose. Then use the same circular motion. Then feel the lumps and lymph nodes. Normal lymph node cannot be felt. So if patient feels something, you have to take it as the abnormal. Now enlarged lymph nodes are about the size of a pencil eraser, but larger than a thinner and longer than thinner. It should be long, it should be thin, and that is how we are described. Diet. One has to check for the nipple discharge also. How you do it? Strip the ducts towards the nipple. So you have to keep on squeezing it and take it to the tip of the nipple. Then normally one or the two drop of clear, milky or greenish tinge secretions can come. They are absolutely normal and there is nothing to worry about. All details in more different ways we have explained when we have other cassettes or other videos we have done. We have demonstrated which type we have to take seriously, which type of secretions we can neglect and should not be blurry or large quantity. If it is, then you will have to inform the doctors. Then swatting out of straining the inside of the prana. So that is the one of the indication. Now check for the other side. Follow the same maneuver. Raise the armpit above your hand. Feel the lump or the masses. And that's how you have to do it for the both sides. Services are available at most of the centers. Patient has to avail them. They should know about it. Now we'll tell you what we have to offer or what we are offering. We have got digital screening mammography machine, which we have shown you just now. It's absolutely a very good quality machine, gives very good quality of mammograms. Then screening ultrasound is usually high frequency. It has got a specific software called elastography. So there are two types of elastographies, one is compressive and non-compressive. So whichever way it is extremely beneficial to have an ultrasound machine with a Doppler and elastography. Then digital mammographic machine and diagnostic ultrasound in addition to that. With that, we have tried to clarify almost all the frequently asked questions by the patients. We are doing it, rather, I am involved in this program right from my days when I was working in Tata in 1984. Since that, we always had our machines either in the institute, and we are involved in a program of breast cancer reduction. What we are finding that if patient presents early, if patient detection is done in early stage, there is 100% cure. Lot of patient feels that if I go there, something is detected, then again there will be some problems behind me, again I will have to go for surgery, again I will have to go this, that, all that thing. But let me tell you one thing, Mammography, screening mammography detects cancer before it is non-operable, before it is not palpable. So it has got the best prognosis. In other words, if at all patient is going to get 100% cure, if not 100%, as much as 95 to 98% of the cure, the cancer has to be detected in very early stage. Mammography detects calcification. If calcification are detected in follow-up, that is when we are doing mammography for the first time, there is no calcification. Second time patient comes, we are finding calcification, which favors malignant calcification. These patients can have really good prognosis. So why we should encourage screening mammography, and why the many countries have come down with their rate of cancer detection, they have come down with their cancer complication by detecting them in a very early stage. The reason is very simple. They are detecting it in very early stage. The cancer is detected early, it is treated early, patient has got no fear of metastasis or otherwise. So do not try to avoid it. In case if your relatives are suffered by it, you have got chances that there may be same problem with you. Approach a diagnostic center, consolidate with them, and you will know when they you should start your getting mammographies. They'll clarify all your doubts, and by getting detected cancer early is the only way you can overcome this disease. So again and again we are requesting, encourage mammography in screening programs. Guys, try to get it done without a fear complex. As you have seen, it is done by female technicians. There is nothing to get embarrassed, and there are a lot of advantages. There are no pains. So with all that thing, I thank you for giving me your valuable time. Please visit our website for comprehensive and detailed lectures over this topic as well as many other topics. I, Dr. Anil Joshi, logs off till we meet again. Thank you. Take care and detect malignancy early.